before we jump into the video, I want to let you all know that this video was pre-recorded prior to EA Play. Also, if you're not subscribed, now would be the perfect time to do so because we are so close to hitting 400K. Last but not least, don't forget to go and enter my Island Living giveaway. Details are in the description. What is up, my little sugar buggers? Welcome back to the channel for a current household. You guys, I know what you're thinking, Jen. Yet another current household. What happened to Yasminder? What happened to all of these other Sims that you have been so in love with over the years, and we've literally never seen them again after the first update? Well, honestly, I don't have very many excuses, so I'm not going to even serve them to you. But what I am going to do is tell you about the family that I have been literally obsessing over. So depending on when this video is going to be posted, you probably have had way more than enough of this family. I should have posted a build on their beautiful La Casita, as well as a entire creative sim, kind of like going into like light detail about their personalities. And I think I've played with them for a total of like 2 to 3, maybe, I don't know, maybe 3.5 hours. So I definitely have like a lot more of a sense of who they actually are. And let me tell you, when I am saying that I am actually obsessed with this family, I really awesome. Do love them. I wish they were an LP. I'm not even freaking pulling your leg. Like, I am so freaking serious. It's crazy to me how that type of vibe happens when you're not even intending it to. And then when you're actually out here filming, everything just feels like it's falling apart. But you know what? It's fine. They're like my little diamond in the rough. I love them so much, and I'm just happy that I get to share this current household with you. So what we're going to do is we are going to go ahead and kind of show you guys the house really quick. You've probably seen it already. If you're not familiar with what a current household is, it's just literally a video telling you guys about the games that I'm playing off camera. And so it's not like an LP or anything quite like that. It's a very chill video. And yeah, it's about 10 minutes long-ish, and there really isn't a lot of gameplay, but there might be. Who really knows? But you're definitely going to want to stay tuned for this one because there is just so much to this family, and I think you guys are going to love. So here is the front of the house. Now, it's kind of going for like a Spanish sort of like ranch vibe. I've incorporated many things from Strangerville, including this little makeshift AC unit, which I think is actually super duper cute. You can find this in the debug mode. And then in the back, we actually have a very small little, I guess, balcony, not balcony, but like porch area. And then over here, we actually have the bell peppers that are growing, and these are Francesca's bell peppers. I love it. She actually wants to extend her garden so that she can make more money because she's kind of learned that she has a little bit of a green thumb. And then in the back here, we have a little bamboo chime. I love this chime in the morning. You can kind of hear it next to the master bedroom, and the sound is just so freaking magical. So for the inside of the house, here is our here's our living room. It's looking a little bit different these days because the couch that we had and chair, they had to be sold so that we could pay the bills, and that will kind of come into context here in just a little bit. But I think I also sold the barbecue that was out back as well, which is definitely a huge disappointment. And then here is our little dining room. I really love the layout of this house, and I love all the curtains and stuff. In case you guys didn't catch it, this family is Latino. Their last name is Suarez. I probably should have said that in the beginning. This is the Suarez family. And so I kind of wanted it to have a lot of Spanish influence. And so I feel like there's a lot of essence here and there that kind of reflect that. So here's the kitchen. This is where the magic happens. This family is big on cooking. They are firm believers that food is what brings family together, and both of the parentals, Jorge and Francesca, are very good at laying it down in the kitchen, and I love this kitchen. It is so cute. I also love like the little dried out flowers and just, I don't know, just kind of, it's simple, but it has like a very real home style vibe to it. And then here is the master bedroom. It's not that special, but you know, it is what it is. Now, the unfortunate part is there are two teen kids. We have Yesenia, and then we also have Raul. They actually have to share a room because this family isn't made of the Benjamins, and they are just kind of, you know, they're making ends meet day by day. however they can. And to be honest, they just don't have the ability to have the kids have their own rooms. And they've grown up like this, so they're pretty freaking used to it. And yeah, that's the little tour. Oh, there's the bathroom. Yay! At least you know where to excuse yourself at. Anyways, long story short, let me go and tell you all about the familia. So Jorge here, he is a chef. Actually, he is a head caterer in the chef career. He loves to cook. He basically was brought up on cooking, very much like his wife Francesca. He loves being able to provide for his family financially, as well as being able to cook them a meal or two. He is a very, very hard worker. Like, he is one of those people that will work their freaking fingers down to the bone. He is great at cooking. He is also really good at mixology and things like that. He actually recently picked up the guitar. So this is his little guitar over here, and he is musically talented as well, as one of his little hidden traits, something he did not discover until he came into his later, he's like early mid-40s, right? So these are all of his traits: fresh chef, active, fully licensed, natural cook, musically talented, and essence of flavor. Let me see. What else do I have to say? Oh, and sometimes he likes to do construction on the side. So when his job isn't, paying the bills, he does actually go and work overtime to be able to get some more simoleons to be able to provide. Now, something about Jorge, he is a very loyal family man. But when I go in and explain to you some of the things that have been happening in the family lately that have kind of pushed him to the brink, I don't want you to judge him for this right here. And we are also playing in Kayla, aka Little Simsy's Simsy Save. All right, so let's move on to Francesca. She is a doting mother. She is quiet, traditional. She also really cares about her appearances. So she's very well spoken. She's articulate. She loves to watch telenovelas. Like, that is her thing. She's a stay-at-home mom. She doesn't really have any hobbies, and I'm trying to work on that a little bit. So she tends to her garden from time to time. Something I actually did notice about her is that she's been really, since it's like the only thing she can do, she's been really obsessing over reading books and stuff. And she recently earned the writing skill when she went to a book club. True story, this happened. Oh, and she really wants to be able to, like, get her hands on a computer so that she can write and maybe earn some money that way, because she would love to get a job. I mean, the kids are pretty much grown at this point. What's stopping her? Except for Jorge. Again, he wants her to stay at home. He wants her to run the house. And that's just kind of like the dynamic that they've had for a very long time. And until recently, it hasn't really caused any problems. They are a strict family, as you all can see. They make real good use of this bulletin board. And this bulletin board has gotten our next sim, Raul, in so much trouble. So Raul, estimated, I think he's like probably 15 or 16, and this derp face that he is making is not flattering. He's actually a really cool kid. He's very active. He loves to make art. He actually has a knack for painting, which is something I discovered. He is a big baby, though. He's had this cold for like literally 3 days, and the other day his sister Yesenia wanted to take him to the pool, and so they went, and he would not get in. He literally would not get in. I even posted it on Twitter, and honestly, I was starting to get aggravated, but after she broke the ice a little bit, he finally went in for like 5 minutes. However, he is a little rebellious. He does have the tendency to kind of like, break the boundaries, and someone that has popped into his life that has kind of pushed him in the direction of being a rebel is this little peach. I think her name is Isa Rosales, and she is a teenager. She's a perfectionist, and she hates children, which goes against everything that Raul would ever want in another person, especially because he's extremely family-oriented. Well, the other day, she invited him out to go to a party at the chateau, and he went. The party was obviously way past his curfew, and he ended up getting caught, right? And so his dad was livid. Not even that he snuck out of the house, but more or less that he was doing bad things behind his back that his father did not approve of, like, drinking and stuff. And he did actually get caught, but that hasn't really stopped him from hanging out with Izzy at all, period. Like, he really likes this girl, and he's been trying and trying and trying to impress her. And it seems like he is doing a lot of that lately, just trying to fit in school, trying to be the cool kid, even though deep down, I feel like he's kind of a little bit of a nerd. Like, I feel like he's into like void critters and painting, and this person that he's trying to paint himself to be, he really isn't. And so, as you guys saw in his inventory, he's been doing some extracurricular activities, which I am literally waiting for his parents to discover. And so, before Yesenia just heads on out, I want to show you my baby, my star of the show. So I actually created her first when I was doing this family's creative sim. I originally intended for her to be an adult. And I was super excited to play her because I think she's just absolutely freaking stunning. She is so beautiful. She looks like a Yesenia, even though I didn't want that to be her name at first. Now, Yesenia is responsible. She is funny, playful. She loves to be spontaneous, hence the whole pool situation with her little brother. And she likes to cook, just like her parents. Now, she also really does enjoy writing in her journal, and she takes school very seriously because she wants to do very big things for her life so that when she is old enough, she can take care of her parents just like they took care of her. I love you, Yesenia. I think she is a smart, freaking sharp girl. I think she's beautiful. I think she is also delicate too. She doesn't really know the things that are going on with her brother, and she is very, very close to her brother. Like, she loves that little boy beyond words. I mean, even though they're like both in the teen category, she did see him in diapers. Like, they weren't too far to where she can't remember, or she can remember, but like they weren't too close to where she can't remember. Does that make sense? I don't know. Anyways, I think you guys catch my drift. So yeah, I'm kind of curious to see who he becomes. He's definitely piquing my interest at the moment, and Yesenia too. I'm kind of wondering what's gonna happen. So right now we have Jorge. He's playing his guitar. He's very flirty right now, and you're probably wondering why. So all of this stress with, you know, Raul and the finances, he went to the bar. He actually went to the Rattlesnake Bar, and he had a couple drinks, maybe one too freaking many. He met this girl. Her name was Candace, and she was actually the bartender. And when he laid eyes on her, he just thought she was the coolest thing. She was quirky. She was unique. He really loved, like, the streaks of purple in her hair. And she was giving him some undeniably affectionate attention. And at the moment, it was just so she could get tips. Like, Candace was not digging him because, you know, he's older. But one thing led to another, you know. And when she got off of work, he invited her to kind of hang out for a little bit. And so she did. And then they ended up just sitting on the little lounge couch, because there's a little lounge couch at the Rattlesnake. And they were gossiping and talking and just discovering all of these amazing quirks about each other. And there was a real connection, so they thought. And one thing, again, led to another. And they ended up hooking up in the back room. Or the bathroom. Oh, my God. The bathroom closet. And he ended up getting home at, like, 1 o'clock in the morning. And he felt sick, not just because of the alcohol, because of what he did. But hang on a quick second. Hack attack. We found Raul trying to hack into the school computers today. We're not sure what his plan was, but we stopped him before we had a chance to do anything. Serious stuff. Please punish him. Seriously? Oh my God. Every freaking time something goes wrong when it goes to, like, the kids at school, they always call Jorge. Like, I'm so serious. There was another time where I think Yesenia was, like, looking at her phone for, like, the quiz answers, and the same thing happened. Oh my God. I was like, literally, you have to call dad. Like, he's the worst. Why can't you call mom? Anyways, school project. Students are allowed to choose their own assignments for an upcoming school project. Should Raul choose an easy assignment and ensure a good grade, or find a challenging assignment and learn something new? Now, I love Raul, but he's got other things on his mind. He's gonna take the easy assignment for freaking sure. Sure enough, Raul gets an A for his beginner's origami, and the little paper frog even hops when you press it. The good grade brings up his entire average by a point or two, so he's literally just, like, half-assing it right now. He doesn't care. He doesn't care about school, but he, like, does. I don't know. He cares more about fitting in. So anyway, the whole Candace situation, he feels horrible about it. Like, he feels really devastated that he would do that. Like, he never wants to see her again. It was a total accident, and he doesn't know what he should do or how he should handle it. So I kind of want to let you guys, you know, fill in the blanks. Let me know. Give poor Jorge here some damn advice on how he should handle this situation. Oh my God, I heard there's someone famous over at the lounge. Want to go check it out? I cannot even believe this chick did not get the hint. Like, they have not talked for a very long time now. He loves his wife. That was something I was going to touch base on. They go to salsa dance classes. They date, you know, as often as they can. They are so in love with each other. Their marriage was rock solid until Jorge freaking screwed it all up for a chick with purple hair. And I know that if Francesca found out that Jorge did such a thing, like threw their freaking 18 years of marriage down the drain, she would probably smack him in the face and leave his sorry culito behind. Like, that is exactly what would happen. And at the moment, I think that's where I'm at with the family. I don't really have that much more to say, but can you just tell by the enthusiasm in my voice and how excited I am to talk to you guys about it? I barely even fumbled over my words, which is really cool. It's such a chill video. I love this. But yeah, I'm very excited to see the future of this family. I'm definitely going to be playing them. Today is currently May 28th, and you're probably going to be seeing this somewhere around the 9th of June. So I've probably gotten in hopefully a few more updates and also some more gameplay. But I do have their life set on long, so there is just so many more things that could develop in the meantime. And also, I do have someone named Jaden Cook, who is very cute. I think he's absolutely adorable. He's not the best influence, unfortunately, but I do feel like Yesenia would really find Jaden just absolutely, I don't know, like, just like gushy and attractive, and I think she would fall for him. And I also think that probably Jorge would lose it at this point and probably toss a popo at her head. But anyways, we're getting another text message, and it looks like Aaron is trying to congratulate us about becoming friends with Candace Scott. Yeah, I'm sure. Yeah, they, like, literally Jorge was like the man at the bar. He was buying everybody drinks, which obviously we don't have a lot of money, and so he shouldn't have done that. And he met, like, Bob Pancakes. He met Teddy Oaks. He met Aaron. He also met Diego and some other Sims as well. But anyways, you guys, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this update here. I really want you guys to sound off in the comments down below. Let me know about maybe your current household, what you've been doing in your game on your own time, all that jazz. I am so freaking excited to continuously play this family and update you guys. Also, little side note, this family is on the gallery. Is available on the gallery at Gen 2606, as well as their casita. I don't even know how he can sit here and have a cup of coffee with his wife in the morning, literally knowing what he did. Like, I don't even know how he deals with himself. But I have a small notion that he's probably not gonna tell her, because, like I said, she, even though she's sweet and she seems like she'll take a lot, that is one thing she will not tolerate. So anyways, you guys, I'm gonna go ahead and wrap up this update here. I hope that you all enjoyed, and if you did, you know what to do, boo. Don't forget to go ahead and comment, rate, and subscribe. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below, where the sun does not shine, and I will see you all next time. Bye, guys.